Hello everyone. So in the last video that I did about SEO as a new world order with regards to the SEO's dream of geo-economic connectivity, the idea was to really just show what that looks like on the map. And to really just understand what very complex terms like Eurocentrism, polycentrism, new world order, and regional connectivity mean. This idea of a new world order sounds great and looks greater. Except there is a slight issue in the plan, Afghanistan.
The US began its final withdrawal from Afghanistan.
The Taliban's takeover of Afghanistan.
It can potentially mess up the entire economic dream. And so today I'll just be talking about that. And also, yes, this is the last piece on SEO. We will move on from Tajikistan. I know. Now that we know Afghanistan is important, what do we know next? We know that Washington screwed up. And boy, did it screw up. Its hurried and miscalculated withdrawal from Afghanistan led terrorist elements, sleeper cells, and peace spoilers in this region to manipulate the fragile situation. Although the Taliban took over all of Afghanistan with no bloodshed, which in itself was a huge relief, but that doesn't mean everything is all well and good. Just a few days after Taliban takeover, the ISIS-K, which is the Islamic State's Khorasan chapter, attacked the Kabul International Airport. 169 Afghans and 13 US troops were killed. Like always, Pakistan, being Afghanistan's eastern neighbor, faced consequences. We've seen it happen. It's right before our eyes. Suddenly, there were more and more attacks on convoys and checkposts in Balochistan. And we have that data. We've shared it time and again, but nothing really happens about it.
Pakistan has shared the dossier on Indian sponsorship of terrorism inside Pakistan. And that's a very, very credible dossier in which entire, a list of Indian activities, Pakistani anti-state entities that India sponsors through by funding those agencies and also through disinformation and fake news. You know, that dossier is a complete set of evidence. Pakistan had earlier shared that with the United Nations, with the P5, with the sense of, bringing forth and shunning this narrative that India has been able to build over a period of years that Pakistan is a safe haven for terrorists.
So Afghanistan's landscape is dotted by a significant presence of terrorist elements. We know that, and as if that wasn't enough, the landscape of terrorism in Central Asia is also changing. And people are freaking out, including us. As of now, the two biggest terrorist organizations in this region are Islamic State of Khorasan, ISIS-K, and the Turkestan Islamic Movement, also known as the ETIM. ISIS-K is a splinter group of ISIS that wants to wage a borderless jihad and take over the Khorasan region. ETIM is an extremist group of native Uyghurs in western China. What they want is to replace Xinjiang with a separate state called East Turkestan. There are other smaller and more sporadic groups as well, those that benefit from ties between different terrorist organizations, sometimes even with the Taliban.
The resurrection of terrorist outfits like Tehrik-e Taliban, Pakistan, rise of Islamic State, and the proliferation of the means to carry out terrorism, they have increased the need for and avenues of cooperation between the SEO countries. So it is heartening to see that the member states are cognizant of the fact that if the phenomena of propaganda, coupled with fake news, information security, money laundering, all these aspects, if they're not addressed, all counter-terrorism efforts will be ineffective, to say the least.
People at the SEO summit realize this. For some context, let's quickly rewind to 2001. SEO was originally created on three pillars: anti-terrorism, anti-separatism, and anti-extremism. For this, it has the regional anti-terrorism structure, more commonly remembered by its rather peculiar acronym RADS. It was only recently that the geo-economic dream got incorporated into this. Because of course, geopolitics and geo-economics are quite mutually inclusive and go hand in hand. A stable and flourishing economy is much more likely to be able to safeguard itself from security threats as opposed to an unstable or dwindling economy. Similarly, an economy cannot fully flourish if it's at risk of security threats. Something like a chicken and egg situation, but yes, you get the point. And so at the 21st annual summit of the SEO, the leaders of the SEO states met with heads of RATS as well as CSTO, which, just on a quick side note, is the Collective Security Treaty Organization, which is a military alliance of six former Soviet states. We'll do a video on that later.
The first of the two meetings in Dushanbe will be the summit of the Collective Security Treaty Organization, a military alliance of six former Soviet republics. It will be followed by a meeting of the leaders of the Shanghai Cooperation Organization, or the SCO.
it was decided that the SCO states will collectively tackle terrorism in the region. This included the SCO's united decision to positively engage with Afghanistan, which basically means the SCO states saying to Afghanistan, hey, include all ethnicities in your government, give rights to women, don't use the Afghan soil for terrorism against us, and then maybe we can recognize you as a political force. Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan urged that sanctioning Afghanistan would only cause further damage to the Afghan people as well as Afghanistan's neighboring countries. Imran Khan also met with Tajikistan's President Emomali Rahmon to reach a political arrangement whereby Pakistan speaks with Pashtuns and Tajikistan with Tajiks to ensure that there is inclusive government, specifically in Panjshir. But positive engagement with Afghanistan alone doesn't ensure security in the region. This region is threatened by newer and changing forms of terrorism, and so it has to keep up with its counter-terrorism capacities. This includes shared intelligence, military exercises and drills, and even newer forms of technology. Just last week, Pakistan hosted the SCO's Pabri Anti-Terror Exercise 2021 in Nowshera. China, Russia, Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, Kazakhstan, and Uzbekistan participated in the exercise. A three-member team of observers from India was also present in Nowshera.
The best part of this exercise was capacity building and innovative approaches and methods which targeted, you know, emerging technologies that are currently being used to counter evolving threats.
With bilateral relations between India and Pakistan at a halt right now, this news came as a shock to me. I was pleasantly surprised. At first, I thought it's fake news, but then I rechecked and turns out it's true.
It is also essential that this positive engagement is converted into actions on ground, like the one, you know, through this exercise, especially in an environment in which Afghanistan's neighbors have to do the heavy lifting to bring about lasting peace and stability in Afghanistan. So I think the SCO countries are largely on their own and they need to realize what their common threats are. And based on those common threats, they need to come up and devise mechanisms to jointly counter terrorism. And not only terrorism, but also radicalization tendencies that exist in these member states.
Being at the SCO summit allowed me to really see what Pakistan and this region is planning to do with its security, and particularly Afghanistan. It's fresh and hopeful, but only time will tell if these measures will be enough to securitize the region. But it also leaves me wondering if these are all the voices that exist in the region. As a Pakistani growing up in the 2000s, I have seen what terrorism does to countries and to people. It ruins economies, tears families, and steals happiness. The people of Pakistan have lived with this for 20 long years. So have Afghans. But are these all the people? What about Kashmiris and Uyghurs? It's important that all oppressed and grieving voices get a chance to speak. And if and when they do speak, we listen. Hello, I hope you enjoyed watching this episode. We've done quite some coverage on the SCO summit and I really hope you like that. Through one of our videos on the SCO, we started a conversation on geoeconomics, and in the next few days on our platform, you'll be seeing a bit more content on that, especially with regards to CPEC, etc. We'll then also be talking about climate change, about technology, what a post-COVID world looks like, etc. If you have any suggestions or any areas that you'd like us to cover, please let us know down below in the comments, and I'd love to read and incorporate. Thank you. Take care.